As a college student doing research papers, it's important to be able to distinguish between popular and scholarly publications. For many assignments, it's necessary to use scholarly publications. In fact, many instructors will require that you use only scholarly sources for your papers. Your papers will be evaluated on the quality of the sources you used, and because they're written by scholars or researchers who are experts in their fields, scholarly publications carry more weight and have more validity than popular publications. So you should use scholarly sources as much as possible when researching your topics. First, some key terms. Periodicals are publications that appear on a regular basis, such as weekly, monthly, or quarterly. Scholarly periodicals are called journals. Popular periodicals include magazines and newspapers. There are some key differences between academic journals and popular magazines. Journal articles are written by scholars or researchers who are writing for an academic audience. Often these articles are reviewed by other experts or peers before publication in a process called peer review. This extra level of quality control means you can have more confidence in the information found in academic journals than in popular sources. Popular publications, magazines, and newspapers are aimed at the general reader. They are usually not written by researchers in the field and do not undergo a peer review process. If you see a periodical on a newsstand or in a store, it's probably a magazine. Journals are usually ordered directly from the publisher and by subscription only. Another way to tell the difference is by the covers. Popular magazines have glossy, colorful covers and lots of advertisements inside. Journals tend to have serious-looking, plain covers and contain little or no advertising. Journal articles tend to be long and give in-depth coverage of the subject, while magazine articles are usually brief, 3 to 5 pages. Telling the difference between scholarly and popular articles found online can be trickier, but here are some things to look for in a journal article. Pull up the full text and look for an abstract that summarizes the article. It should appear under the title of the article and the author's names. Look for the author's credentials and sometimes even a short biography. See if the article contains terminology or jargon specific to that discipline, not familiar to the general reader. At the end of the article, there should be a bibliography or cited references used by the author when researching and writing the article. There may also be footnotes or in-text references within the article that correspond to the citations in the bibliography. If you're still in doubt about whether or not to use a source, you should consult your professor or drop by the library and call 4266 and ask to speak with a librarian.